What is happening, everyone? Back with more Alone in the Dark. Let's... Okay. Had some glitches in the previous episode. Not game of the year, but it's not bad either, guys. He kind of reminds me of Indiana Jones for some reason. I can see it. Guys, if you're enjoying, drop a like. And if you aren't subscribed, please subscribe. Comments, always welcome also. I'm going to look at NES play of this, actually. Is it NES or Super NES? I think it's Super NES.
There's something missing.
That's creepy.
The great library was endless, beautiful, and terrible. An Akashic record for the universe. Inside the mind of Jeremy Hartwood, now corrupted by a story forced upon him, told by a maniacal liar, an evil conjured by science and secrecy. I will suspend a room and lock away the foundation of his character. Its key will be left to the librarian. The only thing invisible to the prowler.
Just want to see what's back here, if there's anything back here. What's this?
Okay.
pain, guys. So we gotta go across.
In the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution. Hey.
Detective!
What?
I hope you found what you were looking for. I fear there is no hope.
So close. There must be something I can work with. Come on, Carnby, think. Think! The shipping company. Prext. Right.
Good luck, Detective.
God, you're here, Detective. Sitting all alone in a place like this. I'd never live it down if the papers got wind of it.
Hey. Ruth, right?
Oh, don't pretend you don't know. I'm sure you have a whole file on me by now, Detective. I suppose we weren't formally introduced. I'm Ruth Talon. Miss Ruth Talon, in case you're wondering.
Edward Carnby.
Enchanté.
Are you sure?
I had too many already.
Nice. It's good.
I know. I have great taste, Detective. I heard you're trying to break Jeremy's promise to the dark man.
Yeah. Do you know anything about that kind of stuff?
No. But it makes you wonder. If he made a promise, can't he simply stand by his words?
Look, I'm just trying to get Jeremy out of a bad deal, so he'll come back with us to New Orleans.
Well, if all fails.
What are you doing?
It's a sign of submission to the dark man. I saw it in a dream once.
What? You don't know the Prext Shipping Company by any chance?
I do. They made big money during the war. Their waterfront office is just over there.
How did you do that?
Do what, Detective? Bonne chance.
Hey, have you seen Emily Hartwood anywhere?
Are you trying to make me jealous, Detective? No, I haven't seen your doll anywhere.
This gotta be like a dream sequence or some shit. I don't know. Let's see, what is this?
Prext Shipping Company. According to the book in Tarawea, the Dark Man is connected to a performance that Jeremy went to somewhere in New Orleans. I'm sure I can find the...
It's locked from the other side.
Oh,
There's a way to get in there. All right. You. Keys. Our shotgun shells are full. All right, that's all I can hold. Come on. It's like steps, so.
No way I can get this out of the way with my bare hands. But if I get that crane going, that should do it.
He can't run when he reloads. Kiss my ass. Jeez, more? Alright, I'm gonna ignore these guys. Probably was best for me to ignore them from the beginning. Oh, how wonderful a sewer.
inside the warehouse. The office must be upstairs.
Damn, we really picked up a machine gun? Oh boy.
Our ship was raided while in dock. All of his things were recovered, but blood was shed. Several men were carried into the Mississippi River and drowned by ones who live in the deep. All items have now been signed and delivered. Now best keep the papers safe. What is left? Later is right. And hell is back again. Cargo manifesto. September 19th, 1892. Breck Shipping Company delivered 4 steamer trunks, 1 Egyptian sarcophagus, and a large wooden crate belonging to the showman called the Black Pharaoh, performing at 18th Street.
Here we go. The address where Jeremy first encountered the Dark Man.
Oh, this guy's still alive.
I'm all out of bullets.
Man, they take so many bullets. Holy crap.
Looks like the fog cleared up. You want to tell me what this is all about?
Welcome, Detective, to the greatest show this side of the Mississippi. Nala Hotel, the Black Pharaoh. the ancient magician who lived 1,000 lives and wore 1,000 masks.
I can see why you settled on calling him the Dark Man. Saves your breath. So, you got scared by a stage magician, and now he's living inside your head.
You can mock me, Detective. You would be the crazy one to think his presence can be ignored. Look where we are!
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we? You were about to tell me how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
No, we can't. You were turning loose on the world. So many innocent would die.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
There is. You offered me a way out. Steps to take.
What are they?
You'll never find them. They're forever entombed in his sunken desert temple.
Jeremy, I'm not your enemy. Tell me where to go. How do I find the temple?
No, we can't. I have to make this sacrifice.
God damn it, Jeremy. I'm gonna save you. Don't worry.
How do you save someone who doesn't want to be saved?
Well, he's gonna get saved no matter what. I just need to find the temple somehow.
A sunken desert temple. I better get down there.
Temple of Nephron.
Here we go.
Thank you.
Guys, how did this turn into Indiana Jones game?
The Dark Man's temple was buried.
It's the star constellation from one of Jeremy's books, the Taurus. That one star's clearly bigger. Must be important. I got a feeling this is it. This is where the contract is hidden. How do I get to it?
acknowledged psychological trauma, breakthrough barriers of self-deceit, temperamentic behavior. These are the Dark Man's terms. The contract. Huh?
What are you doing?
Oh, I found something.
Great. Was it alcohol?
God, no. I just got the wind knocked out of me. I think I know how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
What exactly does that mean?
Everything going back to normal.
All right. I found some more information on Derceto and the patients. There are some seriously strange things going on here. I'm pretty sure two of the patients are dead, and maybe even the clerk.
Oh, yeah. I kind of just gave up on worrying about that.
Well, just keep your eyes open, I suppose. What were you doing again?
Jeremy made a pact with the Dark Man to keep all the madness locked inside Derceto.
All right.
I'm gonna break it. I just have to... Where is it? Where's the talisman?
It's around your neck.
Ah! Ah!
I worry, Detective.
Don't, I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. At least you're a good distraction.
Trust me, you're getting your money's worth. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.
He's all beat up now.
Be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that detective fella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. Ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Carnby seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
Locked. I'm gonna check this, so it should be open. Dining room? That's nothing. It's blocked.
Lunacy in the Astarte Artist Colony.
I need that right now.
I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them.
I don't worry about it.
I think Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office, then.
Detective Carnby, good to see you again. Solved the case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't that great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink. Pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
I better hold on to these. Wouldn't want him to get lost.
McCarthy was... Jeremy knew that the only one who could help him now was the guest in room number 3. The room seemed to have been empty for so long. But that wasn't allowed to be true. The story needed to be different. To include something from the outside, he would bring the guest back to room 3 and show them what was in that safe. 913. But those were not the right numbers. That was the combination for the safe in the clerk's office.
See if we can get it now.
Worked.
The last guest in the empty room suffered from severe maladaption. I must write this down, because if I understand the condition sufficiently, it could make me deny this fact at a later date. And there is reason for me to think I may come to suffer the consequences from this dysfunction, as some who came in contact with the guest seemed to adopt a new worldview, in which everything was predetermined but broken. Upon accepting this worldview, some memories became unmanageable and later rejected. I do not know what this means. I cannot even remember the fate of the guest. I think they were simply misplaced one day and forgotten. just like all documents pertaining to this guest, they have all been destroyed, or they never existed in the first place. Hurrah.
Dr. Gray's office, all to myself. Let's see if we can figure this guy out.
I have finished tidying up Miss Beauregard's belongings. I will leave it to you to contact her agent and have them collect her things. I found one of Grace's drawings she might want back, along with this key in her room, which I believe you've been looking for. Mrs. Thompson.
So that's what we saw before.
This is where McCarthy has hidden my favorite young. It's very important.
There's something missing.
Dr. Gray was somehow mixed up in this business with the doc.
Radiography. Patient Jeremy Hartwood. Date June 14, 1930. Plates. Jeremy's skull proved difficult to capture properly. Partial radiographs worked best. A complete hypothetical psychosurgery based on the ideas by Burkhart and the St. Petersburg research could end up saving Jeremy's mind. Severing the connections around the frontal lobe would certainly solve
mind if I do. That's better.
And we're back here. Well, perfect time to have a look around this place.
Hello? Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait. Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking
Jeremy,
me.
Where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running.
If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river.
Jeremy, where are you?
Is powered by electricity. I need to find a way to turn it on before I can use it.
Ah.
pretty weak. I just need something.
That you were supposed to die.
I'm the catalyst.
I had to die to make the story happen.
What are you referring to, Jeremy?
30 years ago, Frederick needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Find your focus.
Hey!
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in place.
Hey! I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Carnby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
Jeremy was calling out for help, but Carnby couldn't figure out where the voice was coming from. For a moment, Carnby wondered if the boat itself was Jeremy, or if he was below it somehow. It didn't matter right now. Jeremy was clear on one thing. He wanted Carnby to get the steamboat running and out of the mud.